No, she's misses you a lot. Let's start eating instead. Takita isn't ready by and we'll go home. Wait, Nito, what do you want to have?
The body of a 27-year-old woman was found in the grove. 14 stab wounds were found in her body. The body was then identified by her family by her tattoo on her arm, Akari Shoji. The body was clad in her kimono dress and both hands have marks of a rope. Police Manirashi said that the woman appeared to be the victim of a murder and rape. A mountain man discovered the body while cutting grass on the grove. It is said that there's a possibility that this is also connected to the past cases of a woman being raped and killed.
Another case of women losing their purity in their life. What happened to this generation? It is getting worse day by day. Masago, did you hear that? Yes, Mama, I heard it clearly. Good, because you really need to be careful nowadays. People can be dangerous. Always remember that the purity of a woman is a special gift that given to their husband. Just like you, Takahiro, you need to be get married first before anything else.
Of course, Ma, we know that already, right? Maybe the... I need to go now. It's getting late. Do you have somewhere else to go tomorrow?
Yes, I'm going to the temple first thing tomorrow.
Okay, you take care. Lock the doors and I will go here tomorrow. Tell Mama my goodbye.
I will for Nico. Take care also.
May I ask your name? You're such an angel. Or come is blood seeing you here as I am.
I am Masago from the Far Village. And thank you for the compliment. I bet you're beautiful in your youth.
Oh, lady, that's very kind of you. Always take care and trust no one in this area. Did you hear the radio last night? They found another one in a grove. Oh, forgive that person behind that nefarious thing.
I will keep your words, Obasan. Take care also.
Bless your soul, baby.
I'm sorry, I apologize for my benefit. Hey, beautiful lady, what can we do for you? Oh, no, nothing. I just want to give you something. Is this for us? Yes, you can have it all. You can share with your friends. Thank you so much, lady. We hope to see you again soon. Oh, Mama, where are you here? Because I'm waiting for you. I'm glad that you're okay. My heart's been pounding since I left this house this morning. Are you okay? I don't know, Ma, but I think someone is following me. What? Where? On my way home, at first I thought it was just my hallucination. But I saw a black figure on the side of the road. Griffin, you're here already. Let's have this to pray for you tomorrow or the great exhibition. Don't think that. Go change and I will prepare up. But that was okay here. I will wait for you for this class to be sent around. I don't know, Ma, and I don't want to tell him about this. But it's for your safety. Good thing you're here, but first, are you done having a dinner? I can prepare you something.
It's fine, Ma. I'm not hungry also. Do you have something to say?
Yes, they hope you know that Masago went to the taco this morning.
Yes, Ma, she told me last night. Right, Kaibito?
Yes, Kaibito. When she came home, she told me that someone is following her. I don't know, but she told me that she saw a figure standing while she's walking on the road.
Is that true? Are you okay?
Yes, I'm okay. Nothing happened to me, so I guess that's okay. It's not fun. You know, there's a lot of other things that women get killed in the rape. What if you're the next one? I think it's better not to keep Masago with me. Or whenever she goes. You will never know the dangerous person approaches here. Is that okay with you, Leo?
Of course, Ma. We only want nothing but Masago to be safe.
Then it's settled. Masago, you will go with the hero. Don't go without him. This is for you. Yes, Ma, I know you. Okay, that's all for me. Okay, I'm going to stay here with you. You can stay here with the hero if you want to say something to Masago.
Yes, Ma, good night. You heard what Mama said. You need to be more careful, Kuebito. I also don't know what to do if something bad happens to you, okay?
Yes, I know. Don't worry too much. Besides, you're here with me. You're a samurai. And I know you can protect me.
It's getting late. I need to go now.
Okay, let me walk you through the door.
Yes, I do. You
lock
the door and
you'll be done. Mother, he's coming here again yet. Good morning to Masato, but first take a coffee first. Okay, Mother, good morning. Mother, Tamir is here. We will get going, but I remember that you requested for a cup, right? Where is it, Mother? Here. Where is Portugal? Mother, it is so beautiful. Thank you. Welcome, my dear.
The body of a man was found in a grove. The body is said to be lying flat on its back, dressed in a bluish silk kimono and a wrinkled headdress of the Kyoto style. A single sword stroke was found that pierced the breast of the said man. The fallen bamboo blades around it were stained with bloody blossoms was also seen. But according to the one who found the body, the blood was no longer running and that the wound had dried up already. The police suspected that this is another case of murder. The dead body is also identified as Kanazawa no Takehiro.
Where's my daughter? Where's Masako?
Ma'am, please calm down and tell me what happened.
I need to see the body of the hero. My daughter is missing too. They are together since yesterday. And this morning I heard the news that the body was found in the girl and the self-room. But where is my daughter?
Ma'am, the only body was found in the girl. And according to the one who found it, there is no one in the crime scene.
Where's my daughter? I need to find my daughter!
Please sit down here for a while and I'll get back to you later. Ma'am, there is no news about my daughter, but I will update you about it. Thank you. I will come back tomorrow or maybe later. No worries, Ma'am. It is on.
Good morning, officer.
You may sit. Woodcutter, is it you who found the dead body in the grove? Why are you early in the police?
Yes, sir, certainly. It was I who found the body. This morning, as usual, I went to cut off my daily quota of sedas. When I found the body in a grove, in a hollow in the mountains,
if that's the case, can you tell me the exact location where the body of a dead man was found?
The exact location? About 150 meters off the Yamashina Stage Road. It's an out-of-the-way in a grove of bamboo and cedars. The body was lying flat on its back, dressed in a bluish silk kimono and wrinkled headdress of the Akyuru style. A single sword stroke had pierced the breast.
So in your observation, tell me if the body is there a long period of time or is only the day before you found the dead body?
No. The blood was no longer running. The wound had dried up, I believe. And also, a gadfly was stuck fast there, hardly noticing my footsteps.
Have you seen any sharp objects or anything that can possibly cause death? Have you seen a katana?
No, nothing, sir. I found only a rope at the root of a cedar nearby, and well, in addition to a rope, I found a comb. That was all. Apparently, he must have made a battle of it before he was murdered, because the grass and fallen bamboo blades had been trampled down all around.
Since you find a rope near the area where the dead body was found, have you seen anything that the killer will use to go to that place? A cart or even a horse?
No, sir. It's hard enough for a man to enter, let alone a horse.
Well, that's a big deal to our investigation. Thank you for informative testimony. Mr. Gudes, according to your statement, you saw a man yesterday. Can you give me the exact time?
It was about noon yesterday, sir. The unfortunate man was on the road from Sakuyama to Yamashina. He was walking with a woman accompanying him towards Sekiyama on horseback, and who I have learned that it was his wife.
Have you seen the face of the girl who was on the back of the horse?
A scarf hanging from her head hid her face, and I was remember was her clothes, a lila colored suit, and the horse was a thorn like fine lady.
If that's the case, can you tell me the height of the girl who was on the back of the horse? And how about the man? Does he have anything like a foot or something?
About 4 inches, about 4 feet 5 inches. Since I am a Buddhist priest, I took a little notice about her details. Well, the man was armed with katana as well as bow and arrows. And I remember that he had 20 old arrows in his hand. Truly, a human life is, as Ivan said, as a morning dew or a flash of lightning. My words are inadequate to express my sympathy for him.
I couldn't agree more, Mr. Woods. Your statements and words are very helpful to this case. Amazing. We have a suspect with sure Ernesto. Are you sure that this man is responsible for this heinous crime?
The man that I arrested, he is a notorious brigand called Tahamaru. When I arrested him, he was falling off his horse. He was groaning on the bridge at a lot of people.
I see. So there is a high chance that this man is responsible for this crime. To support your claims, can you tell me the time and other details to make this claim stronger?
It was an early hour of last night, and for the record, I might say that the other day I tried to arrest him, but unfortunately, he escaped. He was wearing a dark blue silk kimono and a large flaming sword. And as you can see, he got a bow and arrow somewhere.
Are you sure that the equipment you got from this man is owned by Takahiro? It is quite similar to Takahiro's katana, isn't it?
Then Tahamaru must be the murderer. The bow wound with the leather strip, the black liquored quiver, the 17 arrow with the hawk feather, these were in all his possession. And I believe that.
That's a very informative phrase. But do you have anything to add? Can you tell me some backgrounds about this man?
Of all the robbers prowling around the Kyoto, this Tahamaru has given the most grief to all women in town. Last autumn, a wife who came to the mountain back to the Pindora of the Toribe Temple, presumably to pay a visit, was murdered along with the police. It has been suspected that it was his doing. If this criminal murdered the man, you cannot tell that what he may have done to the man's wife.
Settle down, officer. We're drawing attempts to solve this case. Please sit back and compose yourself. I know how much you're worrying about your daughter, since she was the last person accompanied by the dead man. I'm wishing for her safety. To solve this investigation, could you clarify and clear that this man is her daughter's partner?
Yes, sir. Doug Forbes is the man who buried my daughter. He doesn't not came from Kyoto. He was a samurai in town of Kukufu, the province of Osaka. His name was Kazanawa no Takehiro, and his age was 26. He was of a gentle disposition, so I'm sure that he did nothing to provoke the anger of others.
So you clearly identified that the dead body was Takehiro. How about the young lady that you claim that is your daughter? Can you tell me about her?
Her name is Misato, and her age is 19. She is a spirited, fun-loving girl, but I'm sure she never known any man except Takehiro. She has a small, oval, dark complexed face with a mole at a corner of her left eye.
Can you tell me when was the last time you saw Takehiro and Masabi together? Do you remember the exact time? And where is Masabi now?
Yesterday, Takehiro left with Masaka with my daughter. What the bad luck is it think that should have come to such an end? But the fate of my daughter worries me sick. For heaven's sake, leave no stone unturned to find her. I hate the clever Tahamaru, or whatever your name it is. Not only my son and dog, but my daughter.
A poor old woman, another disadvantage really makes us sad, but we will make sure that your daughter is safe. And I will promise that the one responsible for this will wait.
I killed him, but not her. Where is she gone? I can't tell. Oh, Wait a minute. No torture can make me confess. Now things have come to such a head. I won't keep anything for now. Yesterday, a little past noon, I met that couple. Just then a pack of Lindblom. And raised her hand scarf so that I caught a glimpse of her face. Instantly, it was again covered from a cliff. She looked like a bodhisattva. And at that moment, I made up my mind to capture her. Even if I had to kill a man, am I the only one who kills people? You don't use your swords. You kill people with your power and your money. Sometimes you kill them with the pretext of working for their good. And it's true that they don't bleed. They are in the best of health. But all the same, you kill them. It's hard to say who's the greatest sinner now. You or me. It was quite easy. I became the traveling companion. And I told them there was an old man in the mountain over there, and that I had dug it up and found many mirrors and swords. I went to tell them I'd buried the things in a grove behind the mountain, and that I would like to sell them at a low price to anyone who could care to have them. Then, you see, it's really terrible. It was beginning to be moved by my talk. Before he knew it, in less than half an hour, they were driving their horse towards the mountain with me. When he came in the front of the grove, I told them that the treasures were buried in it, and I asked them to come and see. The man had no objection. He was blinded by greed. The woman said she would wait on horseback. Of course, it was natural for her to say so. At the sight of a thick room. To tell you the truth, my plan worked just as I wish. So I went into the grove with him, with her behind alone. The grove is only bamboo from some distance, about 50 yards ahead. There's rather open clump of cedars. It was a convenient spot for my purpose, pushing my way through the grove. I told him a plausible lie, that the treasures were buried under the cedar. When I told him this, he pushed his neighbor's mind toward the slender cedar visible through the gloom. And after a while, the bamboo thinned out, and we came to where a number of cedars grew in a row. As soon as we got there, I saved him from behind, because he was a trained sword-bearing warrior. He was quite strong, but he was taken by surprise. So there was no help for him. I soon tied him up to the rope of his tether.
How about the rope? Where did you get the rope?
Thank heaven. Being a robber, I had the rope with me. Since I might have to scale a wall at any moment, of course, it was easy to stop him from calling out by gagging his mouth with falling bamboo leaves. When I disposed him, I went to his woman and asked her to come and see him, because he seems to have been suddenly taken sick. It's needless to say that this plan also worked well. The woman, her sage has come, came into the depth of the room, where I led her by the hand. The instant she caught sight of her husband, she drew a small sword. I've never seen a woman such violence. Had been off guard, had got the cross in my side. I dodged, but she kept on slashing at me. She might have wounded me deeply or killed me, but until tomorrow, I managed to strike down her small sword without drawing my own. The most spirited woman and defenseless without a weapon. At least, I could satisfy my desire for her without taking her husband's life. I had no wish to kill him. I was about to run away from the group, leaving the woman behind in terror. When she practically clung to my arm, in broken fragments of words, she asked that either her husband or I died. He said it was more crying than death to have her shame known to two men. She gave up that she wanted to be the wife of whichever survived the inferior's desire to kill him safely.
Telling in this way, no doubt has been cruel man than me. But that's because you didn't see her face, especially your burning eyes at that moment. As I saw her eye to eye, I wanted to make her my wife. Even if I were to be struck by lightning, I wanted to make her my wife. It simply sharpened my mind. This was not only last. As you might think, at the time I had no other desire than last. I'd surely not have went knocking her down and running away. Then I wouldn't have stained my sword with his blood. But the moment I gazed at her face in the dark room, I decided not to leave here without killing her. But I think I'd like to resort to unfair means to kill him. I untied him and told him to cross swords with me. Furious with anger, he drew his thick sword, and quick as thought, he sprang at me furiously without speaking a word. I didn't tell you how our fight turned out. The 23rd stroke, so please remember this. I'm impressed with this.
Where did he kiss Beyonce? She should be the one who are giving her statement because she is the last person who is with the summer. Who are you and what are you doing here looking like that? I'm Masago. I am Masago. So she is the fiancé of Takahiro and the daughter of the old woman who came here yesterday. Yes, ma'am. The one and only Masago. And all of our questions can be answered by her.
That man in the blue silk kimono, after forcing me to yield to him, laughed mockingly as he looked at my bound husband. How horrified my husband must have been! But no matter how hard he tried in agony, the rope cut into him all the more tightly. In spite of myself, I ran stumblingly toward his side, or rather, I tried to run toward him. But the man instantly knocked me down just at the moment I saw an indescribable light in my husband's eyes. Something beyond expression. His eyes makes me shudder even now. The intense look of my husband, who couldn't speak a word, told me all his heart. The flash in his eye was neither anger nor sorrow, only a cold light, a looking of floating, more struck by the look in his eyes than by the flow of the teeth. I called out in spite of myself and fell unconscious. In the course of time, I came to and found that the man in the blue silk was gone. I saw only my husband still bound to the root of the cedar. I raised myself from the bamboo blades with difficulty and look in his eyes, but the expression in his eyes was just the same as before. Beneath the cold attempt in his eyes, there was hatred, shame, grief, and anger. I don't know how to express my heart at that time. Reeling to my feet, I went up to my husband. Takahiro, I said to him, since things have come to this pass, I cannot live with you. I'm determined to die. You must die too. You saw my shame. I can't leave you alive as you are. This was all I could say. Still, he went on gazing at me with loathing and contempt, my heart breaking. Enough for his sword. It must have been taken by the robber. Neither his sword nor his bow and arrows were to be seen in the grove. But fortunately, my small sword was lying at my feet, raising it overhead. Once more, I said, now give me your life. I'll follow you right away. When he heard these words, he moved his lips with difficulty, since his mouth was stuffed with leaves.
Of course, his voice could not be heard at all, but at glance I understood his words. Despising me, his look said only, "Kill me." Neither conscious nor unconscious, I stuck the small sword through the lilac-colored kimono into his breast. Again, at this time, I must be fainted. By the time I managed to look up, he had already bred his last steel in buds. A streak of sinking sunlight streamed through the clump of cedar and bamboos and shone on his pale face. Gulping down my sobs, I untied the rope from his dead body. And what has become of me since I have no more strength to tell you? Anyway, I didn't have the strength to die. I stabbed my own throat with a small sword. I threw myself into a pond at the foot of the mountain, and I tried to kill myself in many ways. Unable to end my life, I'm still living in dishonor. Worthless as I am, I must have been forsaken even by the most merciful Kuanan. I killed my own husband. I was violated by the robber. Whatever can I do? Whatever can I...
You just attacked me, lost my purity. You were samurai, right? But you're my soon-to-be husband. You just watched me losing my purity. I can't believe this. I must kill you.
Good day, officer. I am Sora, the granddaughter of Renata, the old lady beside me. We came here because of Takahiro, the man who died in the grove. My granddaughter is a medium and she can talk to the dead people. And she thinks that Takahiro wanted to save someone.
We have a trial to attend, but we can try talking to the dead man, Takahiro, through this medium, and let's go to the interrogation room and hear the side of Takahiro.
Whenever you are ready, you can start.
Here, is that you?
Yes. After violating my wall,
the robber,
sitting there, began to speak comfortably words to her.
Of course, I couldn't speak.
My whole body was tied fast to the root of a cedar.
But meanwhile,
I weep at her many times. As much as I want to say, don't believe the robber. I wanted to convey some insulting words to her. But my wife, sitting dejectedly on the bamboo leaves, was looking hard at her lap. To all appearance, she was listening to these words. I was organized by jealousy. In the meantime, the robber went on his clever talk, from one subject to another. The robber finally made his bold, brazen proposal. Once your virtue is stained, you won't get along well with your husband. So won't you be my wife instead? It's my love for you that made you bind and forward me. When the criminal talked, my wife raised her face as if in a trance. She had never looked so beautiful as at that moment. What did my beautiful wife say in answer to him while I was sitting bound there? I am lost in space, but I have never thought of her answer without burning with anger and jealousy. Truly, she said, then take me away with you whenever you go. This is not the whole of her soon. If that were all, I would not be tormented so much in the dark. When she was going out of the room, as if in a dream, her hand in the robber's, she suddenly turned pale and painted at me tied to the rope. Of the cedar and said, "Kill him! I cannot marry you as long as I live. Kill him!" She cried many times as if he had gone crazy. Even now, these words threaten me to blow headlong into the bottomless abyss of the darkness. Has such a hateful thing come out of a human mouth ever before? Have such cursed words ever struck human ear? Even once, such a... these words, the robber himself turned pale. Kill him! She cried, clinging to his arms. Looking hard at her, he answered neither yes or no. But hardly had I thought about his answer before she had been knocked down into the bamboo fields. Quietly folding his arms, he looked at me and said, what can he do with her? Kill her or save her? You have only to love. Kill her? For these words alone, I would like to pardon his crime. While I hesitated, he screamed and ran into the depths of the grove. The robber instantly snapped at her, but he failed even to grasp her sleeve. After she ran away, he took up my sword and my bow and arrow. With a single stroke, he cut one of my lungs. I remember his mumbling, my fate is next. Then he disappeared from the room. All was silent after that. No, I heard someone crying. Until the rest of my bonds, I listened carefully and I noticed that it was my own crying. I raised my exhausted body from the foot of the cedar. In front of me, there was shining the small sword which my wife had my grab. I took it up and stamped into my breast. A bloody lump rose to my mouth, but I didn't feel anything. When my breast broke cold, everything was silent as the dead in their graves. What profound silence! Not a single bird note was here in the sky over his grave in the hollow of the mountain. Only a lonely night, linger on the cedars and mountains. By and by, the lights gradually grew farther, till the cedars and bamboo were lost to view. Lying there, I was enveloped in deep silence. Then someone crept on me, but darkness had already been gathering around me. That someone drew the small sword softly out of my breast in its invisible hand. At the same time, once more blood flowed into my mouth. And once and for all, I sank down into the darkness of the space. And all I can hear after that are the words from Lady saying sorry to me until everything went down.
So it was the saga all along.
We, the jury in case of Takehiko versus his wife Masago, find out that the defendant is guilty of the charge of murder. Thank you, everyone. Court is adjourned.
Mother, can you go claim Takehiro's body and lay him near the temple? I wanted him to take rest peacefully and to visit him every day when I get out of here. Please.
Of course, my dear Masago. I will do that. I promise.